Good morning, my name is Mike, and I know it has been one hot minute since I've made a laptop video, but I'd like to introduce you to this HP Pavilion X360 2-in-1 convertible. It's crap. It's a really doggy machine, but that's not what makes this video interesting. What happened here is that I was at the local Value Village, which is a thrift store, and I saw this laptop listed for $24.99 with the power supply. So what I did was I powered it up really quickly inside the store. There was no password on it. And when I started getting into it, I realized there's all these documents on this machine. There was employment records. There was medical records. There was personal photos. This thing was loaded with information. And not to mention that, but it also had what we in Canada call a SIM card, which is like your social identification card. It's what controls everything you do at the government, right out in the open. I could basically copy their identification. Really scary stuff. So let's take a closer look at it, shall we? So we'll start with the power supply. So this does have the Mickey Mouse style plug right here. This is a genuine HP power supply, 19.5 volt, 2.31 amp, 45 watt. And that came with it. That right there, to me, is a bonus because it's not too easy to find these HP power supplies. Now, the laptop itself, like I said, it is the 2-in-1 convertible. So that means that it can fold all the way back and be used as a tablet right there. The keyboard does not fold down, unlike the Yoga, which I find collapses the keys so they don't become accessible. Hinges are pretty solid. All in all, it is a fantastic machine hardware-wise, like the way it's built. Starting up here, we have a power button. We have, I don't know what the heck that is. Super speed USB-A's. We have the headphone microphone jack. Right here, we have the volume control, hard drive light, dent, few screws. On this side, we have a SD card reader, another high-speed USB-A port, HDMI, and that's where the power supply goes. Hinges on the back, ventilation on the bottom, a couple screws under here because I've already taken it apart. And you can see right there it says input 19.5 volt, HP Pavilion X360 convertible, model, blah, 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 serial number, who cares. And it's presentable. Says that it has Bose speakers and it runs a Pentium inside. Well, a Pentium might be really pushing it. I wouldn't give it that much credit. And then it does have this touch screen up here, which is really handy as well. So what I ended up doing was I took it all apart. I pulled out the old hard drive, which was a really slow 5400. I did have a 1 terabyte hybrid drive, which is part SSD and part 7200 RPM drive. It's still not very fast, but it's all I had on me. I thought I had a faster SSD, but I didn't at the time, and I didn't want to waste the only M2 that I had available to put in there. So I took it apart, which was a royal pain in the ass because it's an HP and they're just difficult to work with. There was a 4 gig stick underneath the keyboard that I had to completely pull it all apart to get to. And I didn't have any RAM that would work with it due to the speed of the memory. So I stuck the 4 gig back into it, and this is what we have. So what we're going to do now is we are going to install a new OS on this hard drive and hopefully make this a new machine. Okay, so after some dicking around, it's not going to work well with, well, maybe I can still get Ubuntu on there, but it's giving me some issues. So I'm in the BIOS. You can see it's the HP Pavilion X360 convertible, Pentium N4200, 4 gigs of RAM. I don't have RAM that's compatible with this. Blah, 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 blah. Security, system configuration, exit. So we're going to go into boot options. And we're going to be able to try and, we're going to set it up so it can boot from the USB. And then I got to decide what OS we're going to put on it, I guess. I really wish I could put Ubuntu on it, but maybe I can. I guess I should have recorded myself swapping out the hard drive and putting in the RAM and taking this thing all apart, but I was just losing my temper. So I'm going to install Ubuntu on it. Oh my God, of course the keyboard's not working. Shit. Shit. Son of a bitch. All right. Let me try an external keyboard really quick, or I'll try resetting this thing. God, I just can't stand HP computers. F10, save and exit. Okay, let's see what happens here. So I'm going to try booting with Ubuntu, and hopefully that will make it work. If it turns on. You got power. Oh, operating system mode change. Change the operating system, blah, blah, blah. 4601 plus enter. Escape, continue with changing. Does that mean press the plus key and enter? Enter. 4601, 4601, enter. Huh? Hello? Anyone home? Aha, try or install Ubuntu. Well, I would very much like to try it, thank you. Holy shit, this thing is slow. My God. What a POS. In case you don't know what that stands for. All right. Maybe. Come on. There we go, big boy. Okay, let's come back in a minute and see how it goes. So all in all, everything seems to be working pretty well. No issues. Let me just get some power in here. Even though, let me show you the battery really quick. The battery is estimating. I've had no issues with the battery yet, though. And I've ran this for probably a couple hours before it even got in here. So discharging. Battery's at 80%. Like I said, touchscreen's working. Sound is working. Software updates available. Download. The only thing that's giving me a hard time right now is the auto-rotate. So I can't seem to rotate it, at least not yet. So using it in a tablet mode works fine, but then I have to actually go in there and turn on the on-screen keyboard, for example. Password is password. Yeah, it's a little slow, a little doggy. I would like to add more memory to it. Does this thing have the camera? There it is. See how long it takes for this to boot. There's an airplane video from the webcam. Well, that answers everything you need to know. So, obviously I need to update drivers for that. Not perfect, but for $25, that's a keeper. Pretty happy with it. The person's information, well, if I can find them, it's right here. If I can't find them, then eventually this will end up with a drill through it or something, because I'm not going to hunt them down that much to get it. I'm going to presume or assume that someone had passed on and they took this to Value Village and left it there, but then Value Village did not run any kind of erasure on it. Erasure, the band. They didn't erase anything at all, so that's how I got it, and I'm glad that I got it and not someone else. I mean, you could do some pretty unscrupulous things with this. So if you have any questions or comments, leave them below. Let me know what you think. And we'll be back to our regularly scheduled dash cam videos shortly. And if you like this kind of video, I have a whole collection of computer review videos right there. Literally hundreds. Figuratively hundreds. Hundreds and hundreds. Okay, I'm out of here. Thanks for watching.